What to expect when buying a home in Sun City Summerlin. So what we're talking about today, let's roll. Everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Angela O'Hare, your favorite Las Vegas realtor. And today I'm going to go over what you can expect when you buy a home in Sun City Summerlin. As you know, and as you've probably seen, I've done numerous videos on this awesome 55 plus master planned retirement community. What's not to love about Sun City Summerlin? Well, Sun City Summerlin was Del Webb's first active adult community here in Las Vegas, and it is actually the largest retirement community here in Las Vegas. And it's nestled within the Spring Mountain Range at an elevation of 3,000 feet. Construction began in 1989 by Del Webb and completed 10 years later. So Sun City Summerlin is built in three phases. There's the first phase, which is obviously the older phase, built in 1989, and then the second phase, and then phase three. Phase three is off of Lake Mead and Anasazi, between Anasazi and the 215. Phase two is off of Lake Mead, which would be north of Lake Mead, in between the 215 and Sun City Summerlin, or Sun City Del Webb, I think. And then phase three is after that. So as you go up into the phases, you get better views, the homes are a little newer, and depending on price, for the most part, the homes get actually more in price depending on where it's located in each of the phases. And obviously too, phase two and three, a lot of the homes, or a good chunk of the homes, are on a golf course. Sun City Summerlin has 7,779 homes with a mixture of single family residents and townhomes. And it boasts four clubhouses, four fitness centers, five pools, two of which are indoors, and three golf courses. And inside those golf courses are also like taverns or little restaurants. It's a city within a city. Even though it is the largest master plan community, the reason I like this community is because the fact that it is the largest retirement community here in Las Vegas. And the reason I like that is because of all the options that you can do while you live here in this awesome community. If you don't like one clubhouse, you can go to the other. If you don't like one gym, you can go to another. If you don't like one pool, you can go to another pool. You have endless options. Plus, there are over 100 clubs. There's crafts, tons of crafts. There's woodworking, there's painting, there's photography, there's beadwork, there's jewelry work. I mean, you name it, they have all kinds of activities. Sun City Summerlin boasts more amenities than any retirement community here in the Valley, including Henderson. Overall, expenses in Sun City Summerlin is 18% lower than the national average. Most people in the neighborhood own their own home, and about 82% of the households are being occupied by owners with very few rental properties. Homes in Sun City Summerlin are on the market for an average of 39 days and are typically purchased at or above asking price. Property taxes hover a little over $2,000 a year, and HOA for Sun City Summerlin is $137 a month. However, if you do live in a townhouse in Sun City Summerlin, you will be paying for two HOAs. You will be paying for Sun City HOA and then also that townhouse community HOA. I can't go over the prices for that just because depending on where that townhome is, that price would vary. Just food for thought, if you are thinking about buying a townhome in Sun City Summerlin, that you will have two HOAs. Another HOA for the townhome community does take care of the front and backyard, and also if there's any issues with the paint or roof, they take care of it. Another thing is if you buy a townhome, there are no fences in the backyard. So if you have pets, unfortunately, you will not be able to put a fence in the backyard. Now, if you do buy a single family residence in Sun City, A lot of them don't come fully fenced. It is an option, and you can have it done. However, you would have to get approval through the HOA in order to put up a, you know, full fence in the backyard. Each homeowner in Sun City Summerlin is automatically a member of Sun City Summerlin's Community Association. And the annual homeowner fees are used for financing the operation and maintenance of the association, to landscape and maintain the common areas, to preserve, enhance, and protect the assets of the community, and to finance the programming and management of the amenities for the benefit of the homeowners. When you buy a home in Sun City Summerlin, every buyer will be charged a one-time NORA fee. And NORA stands for New Owner Reserve Assessment. And that's approximately around $1,710. Also, when you buy in Sun City Summerlin, you are also charged the full year's worth of HOA dues on top of the NORA assessment. Just FYI on that. Next, I'm going to go over the amenities for each of the clubhouse. And the first clubhouse is Desert Vista. And Desert Vista has a community center, a fitness center, aerobics room, a grand ballroom, a billiards room, ceramic studio, arts and crafts studio, sewing room, multi-purpose rooms, outdoor pool and spa, tennis courts, pickleball courts, bocce ball courts, basketball court, horseshoe pits, crafty critters, model builders, and photography. So that's a lot at the Desert Vista Community Center. Next, at the Mountain Shadows Community Center, it has an indoor pool, table tennis, outdoor track, outdoor lap pool, tennis courts, shuffleboard courts, horseshoe pits, scenic lakes and ponds, picnic area, library, card rooms, ballroom, administrative and membership offices, architectural and compliance office, human resources, Link Magazine office, and information technology office. Pinnacle Community Center, they have a clubhouse, a 312-seat Starbright Theater, which is awesome, exercise room, multi-purpose room, woodworking shop, massage room, music room, the Summit Restaurants, the 18-hole golf course, outdoor pool and spa, outdoor patio, outdoor walking trail, 4 tennis courts, softball field, snack bar, and computer lab. And last, at the Sun Shadows Community Center, they have obviously the clubhouse, the Olympic size indoor pool and spa, aerobics and dance studio, hobby and game room, meeting rooms, card rooms, multi-purpose rooms, and bocce ball courts. So as you can see, Sun City Summerlin has tons of amenities that you can enjoy. I mean, wow, that's a lot of stuff. I especially like the Starbright Theater, which is pretty cool. Once things get back to normal, they will be putting on shows. They usually have comedy acts, they have musical acts, you name it, they have it all there. And then obviously Sun City Summerlin has 3 golf courses, which is the Highland Falls Golf Course, the Palm Valley Golf Course, and the Eagle Crest Golf Course. Can you see why it's my favorite retirement community? I mean, you will never get bored here. 3 golf courses, 4 community centers, 5 pools, restaurants, you name it, you would never have to leave the community. And did I mention it's a golf cart community? If you want to learn more about Sun City Summerlin, I've done a couple of videos on it. Just check out my YouTube channel. I'll try to remember to post one up above. Other than that, I also have a website, summerlincommunities.com, where I have all the information about Sun City Summerlin. I just felt that it was important to at least let you know when you're buying in this community what to expect when you're buying in this awesome retirement community. One, the HOA is $137 a month. 2, the one-time NORA assessment fee that you have to pay of $1,710. And then 3, all the amenities that is offered in this awesome community. Okay. As always, if you like this video, be sure to hit the thumbs up button, leave a comment down below, share with a friend, and subscribe to my channel. I love talking about Summerlin and Sun City Summerlin. If you're thinking about buying or selling in the Sun City Summerlin area, you can always give me a call at 702-370-5112. Or I've posted a link to a buyer-seller form down in the description below. Thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you guys on the next one.